Hello, everyone. My name is Kevin Keneally, and I work at the University Career Center. Today, I will be walking you through how to navigate and access a virtual career fair at the University of Maryland. So we host our career fairs on Careers4Terps. So the first step is to log into Careers4Terps, which you can access by going to this URL up here, careers.umd.edu/careers4terps. Then you'll click on students and sign in with your UMD credentials. Once you sign in, you will see this homepage on Careers4Terps. And then on this left navigation bar, you're going to want to go to events/career fairs. This will bring you to the full list of our events. You can use the keyword search. What I would recommend here is sorting by type. You can sort by career fairs, hit apply, and then all of the career fairs that are currently scheduled will show on the list here. I'm going to use this demo career fair to walk you through this process. So this is what the career fair will look like when you arrive. The first thing you're going to want to do is click this attend button. You'll be able to say that you're online. You can add your resume so that you can upload multiple resumes and select which resume you would like to share with employers on Careers4Terps. And then it will also show your profile. And so this will show your degree, when you're going to graduate. And so if you see any incorrect information here, you can certainly edit it. If you go up to the top here and click on your initials, you'll see a button that says personal information, academic career information, and you can edit your information there. Once you're ready though, you'll see these few tabs here. So overview, employers, and video chats. Overview will give you a little bit of basic information about the fair, but the main chunk of the fair exists on this employers tab. And so here, for the purposes of this demo fair, we have two representatives online. However, in a normal career fair, you would see a lot more employers on here. And essentially what I want to show you here is if you were to click on an employer that you're interested in, you'll see a full about page. This isn't necessarily filled out because it's a demo fair. However, they'll here provide information about their company, maybe some contact information, maybe some of the hiring opportunities that they have, whether they're jobs or internships. And so there you can find some more information. And then I'll go back really quickly. You'll see there are also two pieces, two types of ways that you can engage with employers. And so one way is through a group chat. So if you click on an employer's name, they might write it in their about description as well. But if you see group chat, and that's something that they're offering, you'll be able to click on this and then you'll see instructions about how to join their group chat. This essentially means that they are not necessarily providing a one-on-one session. Maybe they're providing one-on-one and group chats. They'll be clear about that in their description. And so that is a way for you to engage with employers in the career fair. Another way for you to engage is to join a queue and to meet with an employer one-on-one. And so you'll see here this join queue button. You'll also see if I go back to the full employer list, the little speech bubble with the plus on it, that's how you join a queue. And then in this section on the right, you have upcoming video chats. There you will see any queues that you have joined. You can join up to 5 queues at once. And I'll kind of explain that a little bit more shortly after this. However, what I want to show you here is if you were to join this queue, what happens when an employer might invite you? So I have joined the queue for University of Maryland. You see that here it says that I have an upcoming video chat with the University of Maryland. My estimated wait time is 10 minutes. Usually that would mean that there is one person in line before you, because it will often say 10 minutes is the length of one expected appointment. So if there are 3 people in front of you, it might say 30 minutes. And that's essentially how that works there. And so at this point, we're just going to wait a second to get the invite for University of Maryland. And so when this invite will pop up, I have a coworker helping me with this. Once the invite will pop up, it will pop up at the top. And so then we will be able to join the chat, and it will offer us a button that we click on, and then it will show us whether they're meeting on Zoom or Google Meet or WebEx or any video platform that they might be using. It will provide the link to join that call so that you can have a one-on-one conversation with the employer. So now we see the University of Maryland is ready to chat. So click on join chat. And then here is where you will see, this is we're not going to join this for this sample video. However, if you were actually in the fair and you were about to meet with this employer, you would see the name of their representative there, and you would be able to join their call by using this. And so one thing I will mention is that you will be able to have the employer access your resume simply by uploading it earlier. You don't necessarily need to share it with them separately. You also get their contact information here. So the system is kind of built to make this an easy process for you. And then once you are done with the chat, you'll be able to leave, in this case, the Zoom call. You'll be back at this screen and you can hit end chat. Once you hit end chat, you will see the chat summary. So you'll see what time you met with them, how long it was, who you met with, and then you will be able to take notes on your call. And so you can maybe make a note about, you know, a piece of conversation that you had, whether that was you learned about an internship opportunity or you learned about what this company does that was really exciting to you. So then I will just, for this purpose, write, we had a good meeting. Obviously, you want to be a little bit more detailed than that on the day of. But that's essentially how it works. And then, so it will be logged in your video chats section. So then any video chats that you have, you'll be able to click on it, review your notes that you had written before, add to your notes. And then essentially you would go back, if you're looking to engage further in the fair, you'd go back to the employer list and start all over by adding yourself to a queue or joining a group chat. And so one last point that I will make about the video chats, the one-on-one video chats, if you add yourself to a queue, if you end up being in two queues that are, you know, they both say 10 minutes wait time, and then you're worried about them both being at the same time, the system is built so that if you join one call, it will hold your space in line until you're out of that previous call. So you won't necessarily lose your spot in the second line. However, it will show the employer that you are unavailable at that time, that you're busy. And then once it shows, the system shows that you're available, after you end your previous call, they'll be able to invite you when they're available. And so that is a basic overview of how you can engage in a virtual career fair at the University of Maryland. I hope you found this video helpful and wish you the best of luck on your own career fair process. Thank you.